Okay, we're going to cover the order of operations. I call this basic because we're doing problems that don't have negative numbers. So first of all, let's think about these words. Well, what are the basic operations? What am I talking about? That would be addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. There are other operations you might have to perform. Simplifying problems with exponents, simplifying within parentheses or other grouping symbols, so you might have parentheses, braces, or brackets. So the order of operations, what does that mean? It specifies what to do first when simplifying an expression that has more than one operation. So for instance, there might be parentheses, there might be an addition, but there also might be a multiplication, etc. Okay, so here is the order of operations. First, you simplify within each grouping symbol, starting with the innermost set. That means if there are parentheses or braces or brackets, any other kind of grouping symbols, you're going to simplify inside that first. Second, you're going to evaluate any problems with exponents. Or you could rewrite that as a multiplication. For instance, 5 cubed, you could write as 5 times 5 times 5. Third, reading from left to right, you'll do any multiplication or division. So it's not the multiplication comes first, it's whatever comes first as you're reading the problem from left to right. And fourth, again, reading from left to right, you do any addition or subtraction. So the last thing you ever do in the order of operations is addition or subtraction, unless that's inside a grouping symbol. Okay, this is a big warning. Multiplication is not necessarily done before division. A lot of people make that mistake. And addition is not necessarily done before subtraction. It depends what comes first as you read left to right. So let's just start off with some examples. Here are two examples. 15 minus 2 times 4. All right, so there's no grouping symbols, no parentheses, etc. There's no exponents. The third thing was any multiplication or division. Now, here is a multiplication. So I'm going to do that first. So I copy the problem. And I do that multiplication. So 15 minus 2 times 4 is now 15 minus 8. Now there's no multiplication or division left. I do any addition or subtraction. And all there is subtraction. So 15 minus 8 is 7. Okay? So this simplifies to 7. All right, let's look at the next one. There are no grouping symbols. So the next thing is, are there exponents? And there are exponents. Now what I'm going to do is rewrite this what it means. 5 squared means 5 times 5. Now, you don't have to do that. You can do that in your head. All right, next part. Any multiplication? Well, there's one multiplication, and it's right here. So we're going to do that. So that'll be 25 minus 3 plus 8. Notice I haven't done any addition or subtraction yet. All right, lastly, we do any addition or subtraction going from left to right. So I need to go from left to right. So the first thing I need to do is that subtraction. So that gives you 22, right, plus 8. And now all I have is an addition left, and so my answer is 30. A common mistake would be to add the 3 plus 8. And if you did that, you would get the wrong answer, because 25 minus 11 is not 30. So the correct answer to this is 30. Correct answer to this is 7. Now let's see how this would change if I would have used some grouping symbols over here on the left. Let's say I had done this problem. 15 minus 2, let's say there would have been parentheses around that, times 4. This would be a different problem. So now, because I have the 15 minus 2 in parentheses, I would get 13 times 4. And 13 times 4 is 52. Hey, by the way, an easy way to remember 13 times 4 when you see it, think of a deck of cards. There's 13 in each suit and 4 suits. Hopefully you know there's 52 cards in a deck. So 13 times 4 is 52. Okay, what about this other one? What if there would have been parentheses? Oops, that's not what I meant to do. I meant to put the parentheses around the other part. So what if this problem is 5 squared minus 3 plus 8? This is a completely different problem. I would first simplify it inside the parentheses. So this would give me 5 squared minus 11. And then I could do the 5 squared. All right, this time I'm just going to do that in my head. 5 squared is 5 times 5, so that's 25 minus 11. And that's equal to 13. So you can see that parentheses around part of the problem can make a real difference in the final answer. Here are a couple of other problems. All right, so the first one we have, 48 divided by 6 times 4. All right, there are no parentheses or other grouping symbols, and there are no exponents. And so the next thing is to look for any multiplication or division, and I do have both. So I have to go from left to right. So I first have to do 48 divided by 6, which is 8. And keep copying, so I have 8 times 4. And now all I have is the multiplication, 8 times 4. I have the answer of 32. Now, let's say this had been a different problem. 48 divided by 6 times 4. In this case, I would have done what was in the parentheses first. So 6 times 4 is 24, and then I have to do 48 divided by 24 to get a 2. So you see again how the parentheses around something could make quite a difference in the answer. All right, let's look at this other one. All right, we have grouping symbols here, so that means inside parentheses I have to simplify. So I have to copy. A lot of people skip this part. Copy everything up to the parentheses, and now inside the parentheses I have to use the order of operations. All right, so inside the parentheses I have exponents. So I need to do 2 cubed, or if you want you could write that as 2 times 2 times 2 and do that at the next step. So again, that's an option to do that in your head or to first write it out. And now what I'm going to do is my multiplication. So whether you do it at, you can think of that as writing the exponents out. Either on the first step you're going to write 10 minus 8, or on the second step you'll write 10 minus 8. Depends if you wrote this as this middle step here, the 2 times 2 times 2 out or not. Okay, by the way, notice I do not do 4 plus 5. You must do what's inside the parentheses first. I'm not done simplifying inside the parentheses. All right, so here we go. Inside the parentheses. Okay, now here's a little bit of a tricky part. What does this mean? You have a 5 next to a parentheses. Anytime you have a number next to a parentheses, it means multiply. So the next step in this problem, we've already done all the exponents, and we simplified inside the parentheses. You have to realize this means 5 times 2. If you want, you can write it as 5 times 2. That's up to you. So what do we do next? Multiplication and division as it occurs from left to right. All there is multiplication here. So my next step is to do the 5 times 2. So this gives me 4 plus 10. My final answer then would be 14. Here are a couple more. Why don't you try these by putting it on pause and then coming back. All right, so let's do this. First one, the green. We've got 7 times 3 squared. All right, there are no grouping symbols. There are exponents. So what you could do is do that in your head, the 3 squared, or you could just change that to 3 times 3, which is the meaning, in which case now all I have is multiplication. So we do multiplication from left to right. Now, You could think of this as 7 times 9 or 21 times 3. You're going to get 63. So you could take 2 steps or 1 step to do that. All right, let's do this other one. 100 divided by 10 divided by 2. All right, all I have is division, so we simply go from left to right. So I need to do this first. I don't have a choice of order like I do with multiplication over here. Multiplication is commutative. It doesn't matter what you multiply together first. Division does make a big difference. So we've got 100 divided by 10, which is 10, and 10 divided by 2 is 5. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.